Good evening, everyone. I am Karan Dutch from Government Dharmapuri Medical College. Today, I am going to take a case of solitary thyroid nodule. Patient details: Mr. Parvati, 46 years old, female, is a housewife from lower socioeconomic class. Chief complaints: swelling in the neck for past 4 months, sir.
Okay.
History of presenting illness. Patient was apparently normal before 4 months. Then she noticed a swelling in the right lower part in the front of neck, which was approximately 2 finger breadth size at that time and rapidly increased up to present size. Patient was apparently normal before 4 months. Then she noticed a swelling in the right lower part in the front of the neck, which was approximately 2 finger breadth in size at that time. Then rapidly increased up to present size, approximately 4 fingers breadth.
Okay, doctor. History full of complete pain,
sir. Okay, sir. So no history of pain around the swelling, no history of difficulty in swallowing, no history of difficulty in breathing, no history of change in the tone of voice, no history of fever, no history of weight loss, no history of symptoms of hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism. No history of back pain, no history of headache, no history of syncope, no history of hemoptysis, no history of jaundice, no history of anorexia. Past history, no similar complaints in the past. No history of diabetes, hypertension, tuberculosis, coagulopathy or asthma. No history of X-ray exposure to the neck region in the past. No history of any drug intake. Family history, no significant family history. Menstrual history: attained menarche at 13 years of age. Regular cycles once in every 28 days. Flow for 5 days, 5 by 28. No history of excessive or light bleeding. Not attained menopause. No other associated symptoms. Personal history: takes mixed diet, normal bowel and bladder habits, normal sleeping pattern. Obstetric history: G2, P2, AO, L2, full term normal delivery.
Patient was examined under adequate light and exposure with her consent. Patient is conscious, oriented to time, place and person. Patient is well built and well nourished. BMI is 20.5 kg per meter square. Temperature is afebrile by palpatory method.
Okay. So then vital. Okay, wait panuva namak konjam discuss panikalam topics ga.
Okay,
so more than question answer session oda in the session vandha namak or informative session aachikalam. So now questions I will ask you, okay, adu therinja solunga illana vandu we will discuss about it. Okay, maximum number okay. of points will be from clinical surgery das man. Clinical surgery das and Makanlal Shah. Okay, these are the two books to be followed for our practical, I mean, history taking purpose. Okay, so clinical surgery das and Makanlal Shah, clinical pearls, this called pearls in our book varum, written by Makanlal Shah, and the rendu book da important book for practical purpose for both UG and PG standard. Okay. So what is the importance of age in thyroid?
Sir, where the
which age which is more common?
Sir?
Neethu paathana thambi, endha age la edhu common thambi?
Sir, in younger girls la vandu paathina simple goiter and
okay.
Then sir, middle age la vandu pathina multinodular goiter, then colloid goiter, then solitary nodular goiter and common.
Okay, so younger age la vandu diffuse goiter is more common. Up to our today's topic, younger age la vandu simple goiter is common. Adhu vandu why it is common in girls man?
Sir, sir, because of one is pregnancy, sir.
Pregnancy, okay.
So
nothing but in case of puberty and pregnancy, the requirement of thyroid hormone will increase. Okay, to meet okay. the requirement, physiologically the size of the gland will increase.
Okay, sir. Okay,
so physiologically the size of the gland may increase in case of females. In two conditions, that is during puberty and during pregnancy.
Okay,
what is the importance of location of the patient? location, I mean address of the patient, where he's from, what is important.
Sir, any endemic areas, sir?
Oh, it is an endemic area in our Tamil Nadu, man.
Sir, Dharmapuri, sir.
Why?
Sir, because the water will be less of iodine content, sir. So iodine deficiency will occur, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And okay. Most commonly so, in some other hill regions.
In hilly regions. Yes, so sir. Community medicine, what is the present recent step taken by government to prevent iodine deficiency?
Sir, iodine rich salt, sir.
Okay. That's a national program where the government will provide bindis. That is the bindis, okay? Bindi theriyala rendu pottu vaangala. Okay. And the mari pottula, they have some iodine impregnated bindis. That is the recent thing that is given by government in hilly region, hilly people, hilly women. I mean, women living in hilly region. This is practice. Okay. This is started in Maharashtra for now. So probably this may also reach our country also. One more thing is that depending upon the age, you can decide the diagnosis even in this case, in case of thyroid. So the autoimmune thyroid diseases are more common in the younger age group people. If an younger age group people comes with the thyroid swelling, we should think about autoimmune diseases. And the important characteristic feature of autoimmune disease is that it can also occur in some other places. It is associated with some other autoimmune disease also, like inflammatory bowel disease. Another autoimmune disease can also accompany this. Okay. And in case of old age, multinodular goiter is common.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And the carcinoma is common at old age.
Yes, sir.
And carcinoma can occur even at the younger age when it is associated with some gene mutations. Okay. In case of Men's syndrome, multiple endocrine neoplasia, there's Men 1 and Men 2 is there. In these type of syndromes, even carcinoma can occur at younger age group.
Okay.
So this is the importance of age. And of course, females are more commonly prone for thyroid disorders. Okay.
Yes.
And depending upon the residence, the endemic goiter is common. This is usually a nutritional thing. Okay. This can be corrected by nutrition.
Yes.
Is there surgery is needed for a nutrition for an endemic goiter? Whether surgery is needed for an endemic goiter?
No, sir.
It is not a first line treatment. The two indications for surgical management in endemic goiter are failure for medical therapy, first thing. Second thing is cosmetic problems. If it is a huge goiter, they are supposed to remove it. And other indications are the pressure symptoms, etc. Okay. These are indications where you will go for surgery even in endemic goiter. Okay. Then what is the importance of pain in the swelling, man? When does pain occurs in the swelling? If a patient complains of pain in the swelling in thyroid region, what it implies?
Sir, if maybe any radial thyroiditis, sir.
Any inflammatory conditions, okay? Usually goiter will be a painless condition.
Okay, sir.
Any inflammatory condition of thyroid, it will cause pain. And the other cause for pain is that malignant disease causing infiltration of the nerve fibers around. Okay. The two reasons for pain in swelling will be inflammatory and the malignancy.
Okay, sir.
And of course, autoimmune diseases comes under inflammatory condition. Okay. So, what are the pressure effect you can expect in goiter, man?
Sir, pardon, sir. Pressure?
What are the pressure effect? You asked for history of pressing is negative histories, you asked for it, right? So why did you ask for those histories? Why did you ask for a dysphagia history?
Sir, any compression of esophagus or any tracheal compression?
Okay. Which is the organ, which is the structure to be compressed first, whether trachea or esophagus?
Sir, first.
Relationship of trachea and esophagus to thyroid, which will be first, man? Which will be, it will be immediately below the thyroid. Which structure will be immediately below the thyroid? Okay. So now answer the question. Which is a structure That will be first compressed.
So esophagus will be.
Yeah, why?
So because trachea's opening will be below the thyroid locations. And it is muscular.
This is the reason. Esophagus is a muscular organ which can collapse on itself. But trachea contains cartilaginous rings. Tracheal rings will be there. That cartilaginous rings will provide a scaffold for it. Will have a framework for it. So compression will first occur in esophagus. So patient will complain of difficulty in swallowing. What kind of difficulty in swallowing can occur? Whether difficulty in swallowing for solid foods or liquid foods initially?
Sir, initially for solid foods, sir.
Yeah. Initially, there will be difficulty in swallowing for solid food because of this pressure effect. What are the other pressure effects you can come in thyroid swelling?
Sir, other pressure. Sir, why is coarseness, sir?
This is because of?
Sir, recurrent laryngeal nerve compression, sir.
Okay.
Sir, other.
Tracheal compression can occur.
It's a dyspnea.
Then? And the cervical sympathetic plexus will also be there in located posterior to the thyroid. Okay. So this can cause sympathetic overstimulation also. Why does the thyroid gland moves with the deglutition one?
Sir, why?
Why do thyroid gland moves with deglutition? That is swallowing.
It's a Berry's ligament.
Okay, what is Berry's ligament?
Sir, it is ligament connects.
Important two points are there, man. First thing is that it is enclosed by the pretracheal fascia. Right? This pretracheal fascia extends and connects with the cricoid cartilage.
Okay, sir.
Also, the Berry's ligament also connects the cricoid cartilage and the thyroid gland. Okay.
Okay, sir.
This is why it moves on deglutination. Okay. So what is strider? What is strider? STRIDOR.
Strider
is nothing but it is a noisy breathing, man. And the tracheal lumen gets narrowed. Okay. When the tracheal lumen gets narrowed by any cause, it can produce strider. And this is an emergency condition where you are supposed to secure the airway. Okay, in thyroid patients, it can occur in two reasons. First of all, narrowing of trachea. Okay, when the gland compresses, then trachea can be narrowed. Okay, when the narrowing becomes the lumen becomes very narrowed, there will be some whistling sound. This is strider. Okay, and the strider can also occur when both laryngeal nerves, recurrent laryngeal nerves are injured. When both say recurrent laryngeal nerves are injured, the vocal cord will come in the position of cadaveric position.
Okay.
So in this cadaveric position, the lumen will be very narrow.
Okay.
In this two conditions, patient will develop strider. Here it is necessary to, you should go for a tracheostomy to secure the airway. Okay.
Okay.
So hoarseness of voice is due to the involvement of recurrent laryngeal nerve, correct?
Yes, sir.
So what causes husky voice?
External laryngeal nerve.
Superior laryngeal nerve involvement can cause husky voice. Okay. So primary thyrotoxicosis is common in which age group, man?
Sir, primary?
Primary thyrotoxicosis. Thyrotoxicosis is common in which age group?
Sir, young age.
Okay. Name few conditions, name few clinical features that are seen in primary thyrotoxicosis.
Clinically,
what the patient may complain of? What will be the patient's problem? Because primary thyrotoxicosis is your diagnosis. So at what point you will come for the diagnosis?
Any tremor, sir, patient.
Okay.
And maybe any sleep disturbance.
What sleep disturbance? Excessive sleep or insomnia?
Insomnia, sir.
Okay.
Sir, sweating and diarrhea.
Okay.
Palpitations.
Okay. And even eye signs will be there. So from history, whether your patient is in euthyroid or hyperthyroid or hypothyroid, man. From your history, your patient is in euthyroid state or hyperthyroid state or hypothyroid state.
Euthyroid.
What are the history suggestive of hypothyroid? If patient suffers from hypothyroidism, what will be the history?
Hyper, sir. Okay. Ectopthalmus, sir.
Whether it will be, it won't come under history, man. Okay. What are the histories you are expecting? Which means, what are the clinical symptoms of hyperthyroidism? That is what I am asking you. What are the three points you said for now? That is the answer, man.
Okay, insomnia and
diarrhea. Yeah. What will be the menstrual findings, menstrual cycle of the patient in case of hyperthyroidism? What are the features of or any physiological changes will occur in hyperthyroidism? Whether the menstrual flow will be normal in case of hyperthyroidism?
Sir, no, sir. Maybe any oligomenorrhea, sir.
Okay. Even amenorrhea can occur.
Amenorrhea, sir.
Okay, man. So, what are the important past history you are supposed to ask here, man?
Past history. Sir, any drug intake, sir?
Yeah, what are the drugs that are goitrogenic agents?
Sir, goitrogens. Sorry, any vegetables,
amiodarum, sulfonylureas, okay. Sulfonylureas are the common drugs that can cause that are goitrogenic. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And what are other histories, past histories you're supposed to ask, man?
Sir, that any
other nexivalent, like thyroglossal fistula or cyst operated previously is also more important. Okay.
Okay.
So coming to a personal history. What is your, can you again repeat the personal history, man?
Sure, sir. It takes mixed diet, normal bowel and bladder.
Okay, from personal history.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What are the vegetables which are goitrogenic, man?
Sir, Brassicaceae family, sir.
Brassica family, okay. Brassica family, that includes name some vegetable from Brassica family.
Cabbage, cauliflower.
Okay. So you said that patient has normal bowel and bladder habits, right?
Yes, sir.
So what are the clinical features that can be seen in intestines in case of hyperthyroidism? Hyper.
Sir, constipation.
Hyper
diarrhea, sir.
Diarrhea can occur in hypothyroidism, you can go for constipation. Okay.
Yes, sir.
If patient is complaining of hypo, it will be the symptom of, sorry, if patient complains of constipation, it will be symptom of hypothyroidism. In case of the hyperthyroidism, there will be diarrhea because of increased motility of the bowel.
Yes, sir.
So, what are the family histories you are expecting here, man? What are the importance of family history in thyroid?
Sir, initially told any gene,
what is be hereditary diseases?
Sir?
Hereditary conditions where thyroid can be affected.
Any thyroid carcinoma, sir?
Okay.
Any familial goiter, sir?
So what is the difference between hereditary causes and the familial causes, man?
Okay.
What is the difference between hereditary and the familial?
The difference between
hereditary and familial disease. What is the difference between hereditary disease and familial disease?
Familial among siblings, I mean sister and brother.
Okay. Then hereditary?
From parents.
Oh, so from where the sister and brother are gaining their gene, man? It is not so. Okay, let me answer the question. Okay. Hereditary disease is that diseases that are transmitted from parents to offsprings through some genetic modification or mutation. Okay.
Okay.
All familial diseases are hereditary diseases.
Okay.
But not all hereditary diseases are familial diseases. If you can localize the gene of mutation, that is hereditary disease.
Okay.
If the gene is not localized, it will be familial disease.
Okay, sir.
There's a new study on COVID, man, recently. It is not officially published. It was a study undergoing that because of COVID, it's a common among families.
Okay.
If a husband and wife is affected, either of them are dying, not both are dying.
Okay.
If brothers and sisters are affected, both brother and sister are dying. There is a familial dysfunction here. Okay. Patient belonging to the same family, brother and sister are dying because of COVID.
Okay.
But the gene or the thing that is responsible is not known for now.
Okay.
That is familial.
Okay, sir.
Okay. This is an example of familial. The gene localized and gene that causes the problem is not known. Comes under familial.
Okay.
If you can localize the gene, it comes under hereditary diseases. So, all familial are hereditary diseases. There is some gene that is transmitted to the offspring that causes both familial and hereditary diseases. Okay.
Okay.
So both are similar things, man. But thing is that if you can localize the gene, it is known na it is hereditary disease. If it is not known, but there is some inheritance na it is a familial disease. Okay. There is a difference.
Okay.
Okay. So go into the general examination, man.
General examination. Patient was examined under adequate light and exposure with her consent. Patient is conscious oriented to time, place and person. Patient is well built and well nourished. BMI 20.5 kg per meter square. Temperature is afebrile. I'll pay them.
You're not audible, man. Kekla.
Sir, kekla. Sir, the patient was examined under adequate light and exposure.
Okay.
With
then go for local examination, man.
Okay.
In general examination here, in thyroid cases, you should add about the skin nature, man.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. And also about the mental status of the patient. Whether the patient is conscious, oriented, you said, it should tell about irritability of the patient. If patient is irritable or not irritable.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay. Go for vitals.
So vitals. Pulse is 82 per minute, regular in rhythm, normal volume. Blood pressure is 120/80 mmHg. Respiratory rate is 18 per minute, sir.
Okay, what is the importance of pulse rate in thyroid case, man? Why did you read still about regular rhythm, normal volume in a surgical thyroid case? Whether it is important?
Yes, sir. In a hyper, it will be, the patient will be tachycardic.
Tachycardia will be there, so there will be some extra systoles can be present. So the pulse will be irregular.
Okay.
So this is important in this case. Another thing to be added is sleeping pulse rate. Okay. In case of any thyroid disorder, in vitals, you are supposed to add sleeping pulse rate.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sleeping.
What is the criteria? What is the criteria? What is the grading for sleeping pulse rate, man?
The criteria for?
Criteria for grading the sleeping pulse rate. Below 90 is normal. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So we are using a Kreil's criteria. CRI-LLES trials criteria for dividing, for grading the sleeping pulse rate. 90 below 90 is normal, and 90 to 110 is grade 90 is grade 1, 90 to 110 is grade 2, and above 110 is grade 3. In hypothyroidism, it will be below 90, so grade 1 will be there. In hyper, there will be extreme tachycardia, so it will be grade 3. While in euthyroid patient, according to the Kreil's criteria, the sleeping pulse will be grade 2.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, what is the importance of skin in thyroid? What are the skin features?
It can color, sir.
Okay.
Maybe in hyperpigmented in hyperthyroid.
Okay.
And it will be dry in hypo, sir.
Okay.
But in hypo, it will be hypopigmented.
There won't be hypopigmentation. The skin will be dry in case of
hypo.
Skin will be dry in case of hypo. Okay, that is the thing you can see in general examination. In hyper, there will be
sweat.
It will be moist and dry. Moist and also warmth will be present. Okay.
Okay.
And the skin thickness will also vary.
Okay.
That pre-tibial myxedema, that type of aquapathy that can be also present. Skin thickness will vary. It can increase in hypo. Okay. So go for local examination, man.
Okay, sure. Eyes, no pallor, no ictus, no exophthalmos. Face, no puffiness, no cyanosis. Hands, no tremors, no flapping, no excessive sweating, no cyanosis. Feet, no edema, no lymphadenopathy, no muscle wasting, no pre-tibial myxedema.
Okay.
Then eyes, eyes.
Some voice clear or automatically, I think.
Hello sir, Sipo sir.
Ipo okay, okay.
Sir, feet, no edema, no lymphadenopathy, no muscle wasting, no pre-tibial myxedema.
Okay.
Then eye signs, sir.
Dalrymple
sign, upper eyelid retraction will be absent. In Von Graffy sign, lip lag will be absent.
No. What are the findings you can see in this case, man? What are the positive findings in this case? Just go with it.
Sir, there is no any positive findings.
Okay, no findings will down the last one. If there is no positive findings, you need not mention about it. There's no eye signs. Suggestive of hyperthyroidism. Okay, all that.
Okay, okay, sir.
Okay. Go for inspection of the thyroid.
Approximately. Inspection of the thyroid, approximately 7 to 5 centimeter, single swelling in lower right side of neck, front of neck, globular in shape, extending superiorly to approx 4 centimeter below mandibular margin and below approx 1 centimeter above clavicle. Median margin.
Okay. And the above below is the superior inferior solar tumbi. Better arco. இல்ல அபோவ் பிலோன்னு சொல்றதுக்கு பதிலா சுப்பீரியர் மார்ஜின் இன்ஃபீரியர் மார்ஜின் சொல்லலாம்.
ஓகே ஓகே சார்.
ஓகே தம்பி.
மீடியல் மார்ஜின் இஸ் வெல் டிஃபைன்ட் அண்ட் லேட்டரல் மார்ஜின் இஸ் இல் டிஃபைன்ட்.
ஓகே.
ஸ்வெல்லிங் மூவ்ஸ் வித் டிக்லூட்டேஷன் பட் டோன்ட் மூவ் ஆன் லங் ப்ரொட்ரூஷன்.
ஓகே.
Over like skin, no scar, no sinus, no visible vein, no visible pulse over.
Okay, man.
Then palpations. All inspected findings are confirmed by palpation. Normal temperature in a no tenderness. Inches 7.5 feet by centimeter swelling in right lower part of the top neck.
மைக் ஒழுங்கா வச்சு பேசுறேன் நினைக்கிறேன். மைக் கொஞ்சம் கிட்ட வச்சுக்கோயா
சார். கிட்ட ஓகே சார். சரி இப்போ சார்
இல்ல கொஞ்சம் கிளியரா இல்ல இப்போ ஓகேவா இருக்கு.
ஓகே. வித் அப்பர் மார்ஜின் இன் 4 சென்டிமீட்டர் பிலோ மாண்டிபிள் and lower margin 1.5 centimeter above clavicle.
Okay.
Medial margin is in midline and lateral margin is behind sternocleidomastoid muscle.
Okay.
Smooth surface.
Behind sternocleidomastoid muscle, na, so enna solla varu?
அது வேணா சொல்றீங்களா சார்?
இல்லையா சர்வைக்கல் மசில்னா அது எவ்வளோ அது அது பிகான் ஸ்டார்ல மசில் மசில்னா திட் வில் கோயிங் ஃபார் அ போஸ்டீரியர் நெக் லேட்டரல் பார்ட் ஆஃப் நெக் தாண்டி போஸ்டீரியர் போயிடுவேன். நீ சொன்ன சைஸ் வந்து 4x 5x அந்த மாதிரி சொல்லியிருக்க. நீ சைஸ் அந்த சைஸில் இருக்கு சொல்லி வந்து எப்படி உனக்கு ஸ்டொனக் மசில் தாண்டி பின்னாடி போகும். ஓகே அந்த மாதிரி போகாது தம்பி. சரியா நான் பியான் ஸ்டார்ல மஸ்டர் மசில் நீங்க ஆன்டி போர்ட் ஆஃப் ஸ்டார்ல மஸ்டர் மசில் வரைக்கும் வரும் அவ்வளவுதான். அதுக்கு மேலே போக வாய்ப்பு இல்லை. 4 சென்டிமீட்டர் சொல்லிங்களா?
ஓகே சார்.
ஓகே அதே மாதிரி மென்ஷன் பண்றப்போ மாண்டிபிளுடைய எந்த பார்ட் ஆஃப் மாண்டிபிள் வெதர் இட் இஸ் பாடி ஆஃப் மாண்டிபிள் ஆர் ஆங்கிள் ஆஃப் மாண்டிபிள் வேர் இட் இஸ் ரிலேட்டட் டு நீங்க எந்த இடத்துல வச்சு மெஷர் பண்ணி சொல்றேன்னு சொல்லணும். 4 சென்டிமீட்டர் பிலோ த மாண்டிபிள் சொல்றீங்கல்ல 4 சென்டிமீட்டர் பிலோ த ஆங்கிள் ஆஃப் மாண்டிபிள் இல்லை 4 சென்டிமீட்டர் பிலோ தி பாடி ஆஃப் மாண்டிபிள் அப்படி சொல்லணும். அதே மாதிரி கிளாவிக்கல் சொல்றப்பையும் ஃப்ரம் த ஸ்டெர்னல் ஹெட் ஆஃப் கிளாவிக்கல் ஆர் ஃப்ரம் த மீடியல் ஆஸ்பெக்ட் மீடியல் எண்ட் ஆஃப் த கிளாவிக்கல் அப்படி சொல்லணும். பிகாஸ் கிளாவிக்கல் எக்ஸ்டென்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த ஸ்டெர்னல் ஹெட் டு அக்ரோமியன் ப்ராசஸ். ஸோ எந்த எண்டும் ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்காக சொல்லணும் தம்பி எக்ஸ்டென்ட் சொல்றதுக்கு. ஓகே ஓகே நெக்ஸ்ட் ப்ரொசீட் பண்ணுங்க.
ஹோல்டிங் இஸ் மொபைல் அண்ட் நாட் ஃபிக்ஸ்ட் டு ஸ்கின் அண்ட் மூவ் வித் டிக்லூட்டிஷன் ட்ரக்கியா இன் மிட்லைன் நார்மல் கரோடிட் பசில் வெரி செக் Timbered time, bilateral arm elevation causes facial plethora is negative. Coaches test. Slight pressure over gland causes stridor is negative. No palpable lymph node in the neck.
Thank you, Chambi.
Then percussion. On percussion, head of rear. Then nangia resonant node is off-plane. On ossification, no
okay tell me voice clear hai lapa
sir percussion
come to the diagnosis come to the diagnosis man what is the diagnosis sir, man
the diagnosis it may be a benign solitary thyroid nodule or maybe any thyroid malignancy sir.
Okay, what is the age of the patient?
So 46 sir.
Okay, whether this age is common for malignancy.
Okay, okay.
So sir, what are the features that made you to, what are the histories or what are the examination findings that made you to conclude to a diagnosis of malignancy, man?
In malignancy, sir, the rapid increase in size, sir.
Within what duration?
With rapid increase.
Yeah, one of the history and duration.
Within 4 months, sir.
Okay. So, when you press on, the next question will be, what will be the tumor doubling time? There's a word called as tumor doubling time. Sir, tumor doubling time. It will be different for different type of tumor. For follicular carcinoma of thyroid, it will be around 100 days for follicular, okay. And for some other carcinomas also, for CA breast, it will be 79 days to 90 days. Within that time, the cell will multiply, and the cell will multiply as double the number. So,
okay, sir,
based on this, rapid growth will be determined, man. Okay. So, okay, okay, this is the monthly positive feature. What are other features suggestive of malignancy here?
Sir, other features.
What are the other features you are expecting in malignancy?
Any metastasis?
First you show on the pain and okay. Pressure symptoms are common in malignancies. Okay. So it all may features that are favor of malignancy. In this case, the only thing favoring is your duration and the age of the patient.
Okay.
The rest of the histories are not suggestive of malignancy. Of course, the examination findings is also not suggestive of malignancy because there is no lymph node involvement, there is no fixity to skin even.
Yes, sir.
Of course, from the diagnosis, first from the provisional diagnosis, it cannot be a malignancy. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But maybe it can, if it can be proven in your cytological examination by FNAC or other things, okay?
Yes, sir.
So only one nodule is available, is palpable, right?
Yes, sir. Right lower.
What are the methods you will examine? What are the methods you will use for examining the thyroid, man?
According to Bethner's.
It is simpler for the body. Pizzillo's technique and nothing. Pizzillo's method. Pizzillo's method of examination of thyroid. And where it is used. Pizzillo's technique is nothing but you will ask the patient to hold his hand behind his neck. Okay. Yes, you will ask the patient to hold his hand together and behind his neck.
Okay, sir.
And ask the patient to hyperextend his neck.
Okay, sir.
So, thalaiya pinnadi saakkirappo avanoda kaiya avane avan kalathukku pinnadi vachu munnadi thalluvan. Appo his thyroid gland will become prominent.
Yes, sir.
This is commonly used to examine in case of short-necked individuals.
Okay, sir.
Okay, for short-necked individuals, Pizzillo's method of examination is preferred. This is an important question. In a short-necked individual, the inspection can be done by asking the patient to hold his hand behind his neck and asking the patient to hyperextend his neck.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, what are the structures that move on protrusion of tongue?
Sir,
எல்லாச்சும் ஒரு ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் சொல்றது ஒரு கண்டிஷன் ஒரு ஸ்வெல்லிங் தட் மூவ்ஸ் ஆன் ப்ரொட்ரூஷன் ஆஃப் டங்க்
சார் எனி சிஸ்ட் தைரோகிளாசல் சிஸ்ட் சார்
தைரோகிளாசல் சிஸ்ட் வில் மூவ் ஆன் ப்ரொட்ரூஷன் ஆஃப் டங்க் ஓகே வை
சார்
பிகாஸ் இட் இஸ் எ ரெமனன்ட் ஃப்ரம் தி ஃபராமன் சீக்கம் ஆஃப் தி டங்க் டு தி
ஓகே
ஓகே சோ தி தைரோய்டு ஓகே ஃபராமன் சீக்கம் ஆஃப் தி டங்க்ல இருந்து இது ஒரு கனெக்ஷன் இருக்கு டெவலப்மென்ட் இருக்கு
Okay.
So, what are the other techniques you use for palpating? What is Lagis method, man?
Lagis method, the examiner stands in front of the patient, sir. That glands is pushed to one side and where the margins will be felt, sir.
Okay. For examining the right lobe, we will push the gland towards the right by using your left hand. To examine the left lobe, you will push the right lobe towards the opposite side. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is the other method you know for examining? What is Kreil's method? What is Kreil's?
It's a thumb on the gland, sir. We ask the patient to swallow, sir.
This is used to find the nodularity. Yes. Kreil's method is used to find the nodularity present. Okay.
Yes.
So the important point is that Pizzillo's technique is used for examining the thyroid gland in the short-necked individual.
Yes.
That is the important point to be summarized.
Okay, yes, sir. Okay, sir.
What are the conditions where the mobility of the thyroid gland will be restricted? What are the conditions where the mobility of the thyroid gland will be restricted? That is, it is adherent to the adjacent organ. What are the conditions?
Say in any carcinoma, sir.
Okay. Next.
In a radial thyroiditis, sir.
Any inflammatory conditions. Chronic inflammation.
Okay, sir.
Chronic inflammation.
Okay, sir.
Okay, how will you examine the position of trachea, man?
Trachea, three-finger test.
Three-finger test will be used to detect the position of trachea. Okay. So, what is the test you used to
do to find the tracheal compression? Name the test used to detect the presence of tracheal compression. கரெக்ட் தம்பி, சொல்லு தம்பி.
கோச்சஸ்
கோச்சஸ் டெஸ்ட் கரெக்டா? எப்படியா பண்ணணும்
படிச்சிருந்தேன் ஞாபகம், பட் அதான்
தெரியும். ஒன்றும் இல்லை, கரெக்டாக தம்பி. கோச்சஸ் டெஸ்டா? ஜஸ்ட் பை கம்ப்ரெஸிங் த லோப், எனி லோப் யூ கேன் கம்ப்ரஸ், தட் வில் ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஸ்ட்ரைடர். ஓகே, எனி கம்ப்ரஷன், எனி இன்ஃபில்ட்ரேஷன் ஆஃப் ட்ரக்கியர்ஸ் தேர் ஆன் அப்ளைங் அ மினிமல் ப்ரெஷர் ஓவர் தி கிளாண்ட், இட் வில் ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஸ்ட்ரைடர்.
ஓகே சார்.
If it is positive, okay, this shows tracheal involvement. Okay, what is the mechanism behind the Pemberton sign? The Pemberton sign na enna adu edanal appadi varudhu?
In the thoracic inlet obstruction.
Thoracic inlet obstruction na vera solutrunga. எப்படி பண்ண, how to do the Pemberton sign, how to elicit the Pemberton sign?
Both the hands are above the head வந்து லிஃப்ட் பண்ண சொல்லிட்டு.
Okay, while you lifting the head, hands above, what will happen?
Sir, redness sir.
Redness over the
face sir.
Then what else can occur? Another important feature, flushing of face, yeah, along with enlargement of neck veins.
Okay, sir.
Okay, while raising the hands, there will be enlargement of neck veins and the flushing of face.
Okay, sir.
Okay, this occurs when there is a retrosternal extension of the thyroid. When there is a retrosternal extension of thyroid, the important thing is that inferior border of the thyroid gland, it cannot be seen. Cannot be seen or cannot be palpated. Also, the Pemberton sign will be positive. These are the features that are suggestive of retrosternal extension of the goiter.
Okay.
Cardiac symptoms are more common in either a primary or secondary thyrotoxicosis, man.
Secondary, sir. Secondary congestive cardiac failure, sir.
Oh. Why? What is the reason behind it?
No idea.
ஒன்றும் இல்லை தம்பி. கார்டியாக் வந்து எப்பயுமே ஹார்ட் வில் ஹாவ் இட்ஸ் ஓன் ப்ரொடக்டிவ் மெக்கானிசம்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ இன் கேஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரைமரி தைரோடாக்சிகோசிஸ் திஸ் வில் ஹாவ் சம் ப்ரொடக்டிவ் மெக்கானிசம் டு ப்ரிவென்ட் தி கார்டியாக் எஃபெக்ட் டு மேனிஃபெஸ்ட் அட் தி இயர்லிஸ். அஃப்கோர்ஸ் கார்டியாக் மேனிஃபெஸ்டேஷன் கேன் அக்கர் இன் தி ப்ரைமரி தைரோடாக்சிகோசிஸ் ஆல்சோ, பட் இன் கேஸ் ஆஃப் செகண்டரி தைரோடாக்சிகோசிஸ் ஆஃப்டர் த ஸ்வெல்லிங் அக்கர்ஸ், இட் வில் டேக் அ லாங் டைம் ஃபார் ப்ரொடியூசிங் த மேனிஃபெஸ்டேஷன், ரைட்? ஸோ டியூரிங் திஸ் பீரியட் ஆஃப் டைம் the heart will lose its feedback mechanism.
Okay, sir.
For protective effect. So the cardiac manifestation will be severe in case of secondary thyrotoxicosis and also occurs as a first sign. But duration, the first thing to, it will occur earlier in case of primary thyrotoxicosis only.
But
there is no one point is that the cardiac symptoms manifestation will occur earlier in case of primary thyrotoxicosis only. Okay? It will occur in thyroid, secondary thyroid toxicosis, it will occur after a long period of time, but it is the first symptom to occur.
Okay, sir.
Okay, first symptom to occur in secondary thyroid toxicosis may be a cardiac manifestation because of the exhaustion of the cardiac muscles. Okay, so what are the next question? What are the eye signs that you can see in hyperthyroidism?
என்னதான் இருக்கு
அது மேல அப்பர் ஐடியில் இருக்கும், அது கான்ட்ராக்ட் ஆகிறதுனால அப்பர் லீக் மேலே போயிடுது.
ஓகே,
தேர் வில் பி லிட் டிட்ராக்ஷன்.
ஓகே சார்.
அண்ட் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் மேலே லிட் டிட்ராக்ட் ஆச்சுன்னா கீழே லிட் லேக் இருக்கும்.
லிட்டில் ஆகுன்னா என்னன்னா நீ கண் கீழே பாக்குறப்போ ஐஸ் கீழே ரொட்டேட் பண்றப்போ உன்னுடைய அப்பர் ஐலிடும் கீழே வரணும். ஐபால் கீழே ரொட்டேட் பண்றப்போ அப்பர் ஐலிட் ஷுட் ஆல்சோ ஃபாலோ தி கார்னியா. But okay. That won't happen here. That is called a slit lag, okay? And of course, the exophthalmos. Why do exophthalmos occur in hyperthyroidism, man? There are two entities called as true exophthalmos and false exophthalmos, okay? True exophthalmos is the protrusion of the eyeball itself. Eyeball le peris velile vandichinalum forward push vachinalum that will cause exophthalmos. Adhe maadhiri when the eyelids get retracted on both sides, upper eyelid or retract it, lower eyelid retract it, now majority of portion of the eye can eyes visualize la, so that can also be mimic, that can also mimic the exophthalmos.
Okay,
okay, here in thyroid hyperthyroidism true exophthalmos will occur. Why does it occur in hyperthyroidism? There will be increased fat deposition and right skin thickening and other reason, other things will occur, right, because of cellular infiltration by mixometer substances and the hyaluronic acid. Similar thing will happen in the retroorbital space.
Okay.
Because of the increase in the fat and edema and cellular infiltration by the mixometer substances in the retroorbital space, the eyeball is pushed forwards.
Okay.
Okay. What is Van Graaffe saying? That is lid lag.
Lid lag.
Hmm. What is Jaffrey's sign? Jaffrey's sign.
Wrinkling, for absence of wrinkling in forehead, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What is Stellwart's sign?
Staring look.
Okay. So, what are the other features you can see in eye, man?
Other signs.
Other signs you can see in eyes. What is chemosis? Chemosis is nothing but edema of conjunctiva. Okay. Edema of conjunctiva, man. Okay. Even the cornea gets edematous here.
Okay.
You know that the cornea will have no blood supply, while the sclera and conjunctiva will have a blood supply. So, in case of accumulation of mixometer substance in the retroorbital space, the pressure inside the retroorbital space will increase. This increase in pressure will affect the venous flow.
Okay, sir.
This causes edema of the sclera, which in turn causes edema of the cornea too.
Okay.
So, what type of tremor will be seen in these patients when with hyperthyroidism? If the patient has hyperthyroidism, whether the patient will have coarse tremor or fine tremor?
Sir, fine, sir.
Okay, correct. Why? Why does tremor occur in hyperthyroidism?
Sir, due to any gray matter.
Okay, to be very simple, because of the nervous irritability and excitability.
Okay.
In hyperthyroidism, nerves will be very sensitive. So it will get excited easily, and it will also get fatigue easily because of over excitation.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Sir. What is meant by thyroid brewing?
Sir, thyroid brewing.
BRUIT.
No idea.
It is an auscultatory finding, man. Okay. There will be a murmur on auscultation over the thyroid gland.
Okay.
While you are auscultating with strength over the thyroid gland, there will be a murmur. And this is due to the increased vascularity of the thyroid gland. So it is common in Graves' disease.
Okay.
It is common in Graves' disease, the primate isothyrotoxicosis. This is because of the increased vascularity.
Okay.
Okay, how will you proceed for this case, man? What are the investigations you are supposed to do in this case?
Sir, T3, T4 level, sir.
Okay, complete blood investigation will count first. Initially, you will do with RGs, RFP, LFP, you are doing, and then you will go for 3T3,
that is called a thyroid function test. CT3, CT4 and TFS.
TFS
will be done. Okay. Then what are other investigations are supposed to do?
FNAC.
Okay. Before FNAC, okay, any first of all, whatever the diagnosis may be, we should go for non-invasive investigations. Okay. Then you should go for invasive investigations. Non-invasive investigation may include radiographic imaging.
Okay.
Because when you are going for an FNAC, it may cause some hematoma or hemorrhage inside the gland, where you are pricking the gland. This can mimic or this can mislead the radiologist.
Okay,
some hemorrhage is there, it is a feature of malignancy, right?
Yeah.
So, in the patient, the radiologist can give a diagnosis of malignancy and it will mislead them. So, first of all, you should go for non-invasive imaging.
Okay.
Non-invasive
okay.
investigations. Then you should go for invasive things. So, what are the non-invasive or what are the imaging you are supposed to do in this case?
CTR, MRI for any retrosternal extension, sir.
Okay.
But then,
first on the ultrasound thyroid, ultrasound of the thyroid neck. Okay. Even from ultrasound also you can find whether it has a retrosternal extension or not. And also you can find it lymph node involvement.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Of course MRI and CT will also be helpful. But ultrasound is more than enough. It will be handy and it will be a cheaper investigation and the rate of radiation exposure is less in case of ultrasound. So initially prefer an ultrasound for this patient, ultrasound thyroid. Of course ultrasound. Before going for investigation, you should, as I said previously, you can divide investigation into three things. Investigation towards a specific diagnosis, investigation to find any metastasis there or not, and investigations for assessing the general condition of the patient. Here, we will go for ultrasound thyroid and then we will go for ultrasound abdomen too, to find any metastasis in the liver or any ascites. And also, of course, you should rule out stroma of ovary even.
Okay.
Ectopic thyroid location should also be ruled out, right? So, we'll go for ultrasound neck and ultrasound abdomen. And of course, CT chest will also be taken to detect any retrosternal extension and also any bony mets in case of carcinoma.
Yes.
Okay. Then I'll go for FNAC.
Yes, sir.
What is TIREDS? TIREDS. CA breast lab biraxin படிச்சிருக்கோம்ல தம்பி அதே மாதிரி தான் டிராக்சன் ஒன்று
இருக்கும் சார் இமேஜிங்கா சார்
இன் இமேஜிங் அல்ட்ராசவுண்ட் தைராய்டில் வந்து டிராக்சன் கண்டிஷன் இருக்கும் தம்பி பிராக்ஸ் நம்ம பிரஸ்ட் சொல்ற மாதிரி இதுல வந்து டிராக்சன் சொல்லி அவங்க மென்ஷன் பண்ணுவாங்க ஓகே இது வந்து இமேஜிங்ல ஓகே இந்த எஃப்என்ஏசி பண்ணிட்டோம் ஓகே FNAC பண்ணியாச்சு நெக்ஸ்ட் வேற என்ன பண்ணலாம் FNAC is more than enough in case of thyroid gland okay FNAC is more than enough FNAC should be taken from the nodule okay nodule if any swelling is there it should be taken from the summit of the swelling and what gauze needle you will be using man size of needle used in FNAC we'll be using 21 to 22 gauze needle okay so how many passes can you please explain me how you will do a FNAC
aspiration
is 21 to 22 gauze needle eduthukom we will take a 10 ml syringe we will insert needle into the thyroid gland
Okay.
And you will create a negative pressure and make around at least 6 passes. Minimum 6 passes. 6 times you should inject and you should move it inside. Okay? You should not take the needle out. Okay? So after 6 passes, you should take it out and you should make it as a smear. And you can fix it, you can air dry it or you can fix it with alcohol and the setting for examination.
Okay, sir.
Okay? This is how you will do. So what is radioactive iodine study? Radioactive iodine uptake study.
this is usually performed to detect any impalpable nodes.
Okay.
And also extra thyroid thyroid tissues. Okay. Ectopic thyroid tissues. If the thyroid tissue is present elsewhere, we can use the radioactive iodine uptake study for diagnosing it. Okay. For detecting where it is, okay.
Okay.
Here, what isotope of iodine is used, man?
Iodine-131, sir?
Yes, iodine-131 will be used. In case of hyperactive nodules, it is called as a warm nodule or hot nodule, where the uptake will be more. Yes. And in the inactive regions, there won't be any uptake. That is called as cold nodule.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So, let me give you a condition where TSH is elevated, while T3 and T4 is normal. What is this condition called? If TSH is elevated, what condition TSH will elevate, will increase?
Sir, any subclinical symptoms?
TSH will increase in case of hypothyroidism by negative feedback mechanism, by positive feedback mechanism to produce the thyroxine, okay? So, if TSH is increased, it is suggestive of hypothyroidism, okay? Because when the TSH will be indirectly proportional or inversely proportional to the T3, T4. If T3, T4 is less, TSH will be more. If TSH is more, T3, T4 will be less.
Yes, sir.
So, increased T4 indicates hypothyroidism, but here T3, T4 is normal. So, this condition is called as subclinical hypothyroidism.
Okay, sir.
What will be the treatment for this man, subclinical hypothyroidism? Whether you should go for any antithyroid drugs or any, you should start with thyroxine or you should wait. We should wait for next 6 months, okay? In case of subclinical hyper or hypothyroidism, you should wait for 6 months and you should repeat the thyroid function test.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So in your case, where all the investigations are very normal, patient is in uterine state, both clinically and biochemically, there was a single nodule in the lobe, in the thyroid gland. How you will proceed? You will prefer a medical management or a surgical management here?
First,
there is no complaints here specifically to treat with medical management, right? Patient is in euthyroid state, patient has no symptoms suggestive of hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism. So, there is no role of medical management here. We can directly go for surgery.
Okay.
So, what surgery you prefer here? Where is the nodule located?
Lower right.
Lower right. I mean, lower pole of the right lobe. Right lobe. Right. What surgery will go for, man?
Any cosmetic.
You can go for hemithyroidectomy. Okay. If the isthmus and opposite gland is normal, you can go for hemithyroidectomy. What are the lobes removed in hemithyroidectomy, man? What are the lobes that are removed in hemithyroidectomy?
Here, in this case, the lateral one lobe will be removed.
You are not audible, man.
Sir, lateral lobe will be removed, sir.
Which lateral lobe, right or left?
The right, sir.
Then? Hemithyroidectomy means removal of right lobe or either lobe, either one of the lobe, along with the isthmus. Okay.
Okay.
Here isthmus will also be removed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Remove this. You have done the surgery. Then how we will follow up the patient, man? What are the expected complications of thyroid surgeries?
Bleeding.
Okay. Hemorrhage.
Yes, sir. Any hypo
because of any hypoparathyroidism, sir?
Hypocalcemia, then?
Any nerve injury, sir?
Okay. Epilateral nerve injury?
Yes, sir. So that any palsy will occur.
Okay. Adjacent organ injuries. Okay. So
abstract.
So what? How you will? What are the types of hemorrhage that can occur in a post-thyroidectomy patient? In post-thyroidectomy patient, hemorrhage can occur at any point of time, right? In after surgery.
Yes, sir.
How you will classify it? Like what I mean is that if a patient bleeds immediately after surgery, what is it? After 24 hours, what is it?
Sir, immediately means any reaction.
Our primary hemorrhage, yeah, immediately on table.
Sir, okay, sir. Then after means any infection, sir?
After how many hours it is called as reactionary? After how many hours it is called as secondary?
Sir, 24 hours.
படிக்கணும் தம்பி அந்த விஷயத்தெல்லாம் சரியா எல்லாம் படிக்கணும் ஓகே ப்ரைமரி ஹெமரேஜ்னால் அது வந்து எப்போ வரும் செகண்டரி எப்போ வரும் ரியாக்ஷனரி எப்போ வரும் தேர்ஷரி ஹெமரேஜ் எப்போ வரும்ன்றது ஆஃப்டர் ஓகே தேர் ஆர் ஃபோர் டைப்ஸ் ஓகே ப்ரைமரி செகண்டரி தேர்ஷரி அண்ட் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் ரியாக்ஷனரி ஹெமரேஜ் ஆல்சோ தேர் ரியாக்ஷன் ஹெமரேஜ் இஸ் டியூ டு த ஸ்லிப்பிங் ஆஃப் நாட் ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த எட்டியாலஜி ஆஃப் ஈச் திங் ஷுட் நோ ஓகே ஸோ வாட் ஆர் த கிளினிக்கல் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் இன் ஹைப்போகால்சிமியா மேன் What are the clinical features? I mean, what are the signs you will find in hypocalcemia?
Decreasing.
You have done the total thyroidectomy for a patient. Okay.
Tetany.
Patient will present with tetany. Okay. What are the signs that is elicited in tetany? There will be two signs. Okay.
Ptosis sign and.
What is ptosis sign?
Hand, fingers.
Correct, Ravi. Every panna hoti hai.
And the blood pressure and the sphygmomanometer and the fingers alla vandu.
Correct, the sphygmomanometer enna pannuvom?
Adhan sir, blood pressure vandu appo patient
rising the systolic pressure above 200 millimeter of mercury. Okay. For at least 5 minutes, வச்சிட்டிருந்தோம்னா பேஷண்ட்ஸ் ஹேண்ட் வந்து இட்லா கேரக்டரிஸ்டிக் ஐ திங் ஓகே இல்லை ஃப்ளெக்ஷன் அட் தி மெட்டடார்சோ டார்சல் ஜாயிண்ட்டில் ஃப்ளெக்ஷன் இருக்கும் அண்ட் மெட்டடார்சோ ஃபெலிஞ்சியல் ஜாயிண்ட்டில் ஃப்ளெக்ஷன் இருக்கும் அண்ட் அதர் இன்டர்ஃபெலிஞ்சியல் ஜாயிண்ட்டில் வில் ஹாவ் எக்ஸ்டென்ஷன் வாட் இஸ் செவ்ஸ்டாக் சைன்
சார் இப்போ பேஷண்ட் வந்து ஏதாச்சும் ஃபேஷியல் டேப் பண்ணால் வந்து ட்விச்சிங்
ஓகே ஸோ வாட் ஆர் தி சிம்டம்ஸ் சீன் இன் ஹைப்போகால்சிமியா இப்போ சொன்ன ரெண்டுமே சைன்ஸ் வாட் ஆர் தி சிம்டம்ஸ் இட் கேன் பேஷண்ட் பர்சன் வித் நம்னஸ் இருக்கும் தம்பி ஓகே நம்னஸ் இருக்கும் ஒரு மாதிரி பின் ரோலிங் மூமெண்ட் மாதிரி பின் பிரிக்கிங் சென்சேஷன் மாதிரி இருக்கும்
ஓகே
ஒரு ஆல்டர்ட் சென்சேஷன் ஓவர் தி ஹேண்ட்ஸ் மோஸ்ட் காமன் இந்த பெரியோரல் நம்னஸ் இருக்கும் பேஷண்ட்டுக்கு
ஓகே
பேஷண்ட் வில் ப்ரெசன்ட் பெரியோரல் நம்னஸ் தட் இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன் ஃபீச்சர் ஆஃப் ஹைப்போகால்சிமியா
ஓகே
ஸோ இஃப் சப்போஸ் யூஆர் டூயிங் டோட்டல் தைராய்டெக்டமி யூ ஹேவ் ரிமூவ்ட் ஆல் ஃபோர் பாராதைராய்டு கிளாண்ட்ஸ்
ஓகே
ஹவு டு டிஃபரன்ஷியேட் பிட்வீன் அ பாராதைராய்டு கிளாண்ட் and a fat globule intraoperatively. சர்ஜரி பண்றப்ப மொத்தமா எடுத்துட்டோம் இப்ப பாரதைராய்டு நம்ம கையில இருக்கு டவுட்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கு அது பாரதைராய்டா இல்ல ஃபேட்டான்னு தெரியல அது எப்படி டிஃபரன்ஷியேட் பண்ணுவோம் தம்பி இப்ப பாரதைராய்டு நம்ம அதை ரீஇன்சர்ட் பண்ணணும் திரும்பி வச்சிடணும் இல்ல பேஷண்ட் டெவலப் டிட்டானி ஓகே ஸோ இப்போ எப்படி டிஃபரன்ஷியேட் பண்ணலாம்னா சலைன்ல போடணும் ஓகே வெறும் நார்மல் சலைன்ல போட்டோம்னா ஃபேட் குளோபியூல் வில் ஃப்ளோட்
okay okay sir.
While the parathyroid gland will sink inside the saline.
Okay.
So இப்போ எடுத்துட்டோம் என்ன பண்ணலாம் parathyroid gland was removed accidentally during a surgery we can reinsert it in the எங்க வைக்கலாம்னா where are the places we can reinsert the parathyroid gland is that forearm thighs and abdomen anterior abdominal wall these are the sites where we can place the parathyroid gland surgically if you are removing it accidentally from the neck region then we can replace it in the forearm or in the thigh region or in the anterior abdominal wall by a small incision
okay
so in that place the parathyroid gland will get its own nutrition will develop its own blood supply angiogenesis will occur and it will get blood supply it can survive and tetany can be prevented in this case in this and such a cases
okay sir
okay. After surgery at least after 1 month of surgery we should go for thyroid function test monitoring
okay sir
why thyroid function test should not be taken immediately after surgery but surgery panniyaachu total thyroid panniyaachu patient ku thyroxine next day kudukanuma because total thyroid panna thyroxine production e irukadhu so avanga immediately kudukanuma thyroxine is the most important hormone right
yes sir but immediate kuduk no sir not immediately sir
of course the correct man why
maybe
what is the t half of t4 t half of t4 is 7 days
okay sir
okay till the time before you take you remove the thyroid gland thyroidectomy is done the gland will be producing it right so
okay sir
even after surgery for at least 7 days the thyroxine hormone will be there the t4 will get peripherally converted into t3 and it will act
yes sir
okay and also surgery is a stressful condition so thyroid production will of course increase okay so after 14 days postoperative 14 to postoperative day you will go for TFT thyroid function test and only based on that you will go for thyroxine dose calculation and supplementation of course in carcinoma you will go for a suppressive dose of thyroxine that is a different concept which we will deal when we are dealing with the carcinoma of thyroid okay in case of carcinoma of thyroid you should give a suppressive dose of thyroxine that is minimum of 300 micrograms to be given the suppressive dose of thyroxine and what is the complication we are expecting when you operate on a patient with hyperthyroidism uncontrolled hyperthyroidism what is the life threatening condition expected to occur in a patient
thyroid storm
okay thyroid storm correct what are the features of the what are the clinical features of high thyroid storm
increased BP sir
hypertension hyperthermia
yes sir
high increase in sweating arrhythmias can also occur that can lead to death even so okay how will you manage it how to manage the thyroid storm
any drug propranolol
okay what is propranolol
the beta
what group of drug it is beta blocker okay what is the dose of propranolol to be given in thyroid storm 80 mg okay
okay sir
80 mg every 8 hourly then what are the other drugs to be given thyroid storm means T3 T4 is more right then you should go for
any anti-thyroid drugs sir
yeah anti-thyroid drugs but in our condition in our situation it is if the surgery is completely done and thyroid gland is entirely removed it is not recovered
okay
anti-thyroid drugs will have no effect when the thyroid gland is entirely removed.
Okay, sir.
But usually thyrostom will occur immediately on anesthesia, immediately after giving anesthesia.
Okay,
that usually occurs before the thyroid gland is removed.
Okay.
So here in thyrostom, you will give antithyroid drugs because the thyroid gland will not be removed.
Okay.
It can even occur after the surgery. Just opening the neck region and this compression over the thyroid gland can lead to thyrostom by releasing the excess thyroid gland, thyroid hormone inside the bloodstream. In such a condition, antithyroid drugs to be given. So name some antithyroid drugs you know, man.
Sir,
carbimazole and methimazole are the two drugs, okay? Where it will act? What is the site of action? Follicular cells, okay? Follicular cells of thyroid gland, okay? This is a follicular cells that produce thyroxine.
Yes, sir.
And what is the substance produced by the parafollicular cells, man? What is the name of the hormone or substance that is produced by parafollicular cells? What, man?
Calcitonin.
You're correct, man. Yeah, calcitonin. What is the action of calcitonin?
Sir, decrease the blood calcium level, sir.
Decrease the blood calcium level.
Sir, wait, one second, sir. Calcification, sir.
Calcification of?
Bone, sir.
Okay.
So the blood calcium will be decreased in hypercalcemic patient.
Okay, so blood calcium level will reduce. Okay.
Yes.
Then what is the counterpart of calcitonin? What name the hormone that will have opposite action to calcitonin?
Parathormone, sir.
Yeah, parathormone. Parathormone will have osteolytic activity, thereby increasing the serum blood calcium level, while the calcitonin will have osteoblastic activity.
Yes, sir.
It will take up the calcium from the blood and will give it to the bones.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
okay, very good presentation, man. Let's conclude with this session. If any doubt, sir, people can message me at any time, man.
Sure, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.